basically my what I taken with my internship with Amy. When we did the study, what we found out was Kerala was initially a labor scarce state even before NREGA. And one, because the non-agri wage rates are very high and agri wage rates are very low, so people usually prefer to go to non-agri labor. Then there are like educated unemployed youth who were like kind of overqualified to go for farm labor, and many of them actually prefer to migrate to Gulf countries instead of doing farm labor in the state. So when we started the study, the questions in our mind was, is NREGA a success in Kerala, because it's already labor scarce and people do not prefer to go to rural labor market. Then even if it's a success, will it have an impact on rural labor market in Kerala? So but when we looked at the number of households which were provided employment, we can see that it actually increased greatly. Also, percentage of employment generated is also increased greatly in Kerala over the years. And one one interesting factor in Kerala is that the share of women in NREGA is actually now around 93-94%. So, with this background, we did a study of 13 villages in Parkar. We surveyed 98 laborers and 56 farmers. Out of the laborers we surveyed, we found that 96% of them were women laborers, and out of the whole laborers we surveyed, 46% were new elders. They had no farm labor, they had never done farm labor activity, and they also did not come from a family with a background of farm labor. And out of that 46%, 11% became farm laborers later on. Now, what we saw was there was an income maximizing tendency across social groups, and there was demand for more days and higher wages. Actually, the overseers who were implementing NREGA found it difficult to generate more labor jobs for the laborers. It was essentially demand pull. It added 46% of laborers into the market, but so it's kind of additive thing. But there was at the same time a reduction in farm labor also. Now we tried to find out what is the why it's attractive for the laborers, and we did a perception writing on all these four criteria. The first thing was higher income and wages. Second was availability of work close to home. Third was better facilities at the work site, and fourth was the perception of it's a liking of work. Now, but when we inquired more, we found that there are other factors which actually pulled people into this NREGA, especially women. The first and primary factor is Kudumbashree. Kudumbashree is a state poverty eradication mission in Kerala, where they have organized women and like made a lot of SDG groups. And second is this Kudumbashree is actually implementing NREGA in Kerala. So women actually knew what is happening in NREGA, what are the benefits. So they were this pulled them into the coming to NREGA market. Second thing say is bank accounts. These women who are working under NREGA, they never had a bank account earlier. But when they registered for NREGA, the first thing was they should have a bank account. Now this kind of gave a security to the women, in the sense that many of the farm laborers told us that earlier when they get their wages, their husbands take away the money and things like that happen. Now it's like secure income. Plus, it also gave them a financial, stability also, and independence. Third perception was that it's kind of a government job. So, after the 46% new entrants, they came to the job because it has this government job perception. And fourth one was that government has implemented some schemes, for example, the children of these NREGA laborers, they get 1200 rupees scholarship every year, till 12th standard. Then and they get 30,000 as an insurance. They have an insurance scheme which covers the accidents happening at the work site, and they'll get 30,000 maximum. Third one was that government actually started giving rice at 2 rupees per kg. And if an Areca laborer completes the 50 days of work. So this also again pulled people into this scheme. And the farm laborers told us that mostly, especially in Palakkad, the main crop is paddy. So because of seasonality of farm labor, they also started coming into Nainika. Now shortage of labor in agriculture, what we found that most affected crop was paddy. And interestingly, most applicant activities were transplanting and harvesting. Both of these were traditionally done by women. And the interesting fact is that Nareka actually pulled lot of women laborers into the market. Farmers started having different cropping strategies, modified rice cultivation, there was changing cropping pattern and mechanization. The question then we asked ourselves was, has farmers themselves worsened the situation? No, because there is decrease in labor shortage, because one thing was what happened in paddy cultivation was that Nareka was like an opportunity for the farm laborers, especially women laborers, to shift from farm the tough farm labor to get into a comparatively easier Nareka job. So that actually happened, that again led to shortage of labor in agriculture. So farmers started having bidding wars. So like they'll offer more wages to laborers to pull laborers into their farm. So that kind of bidding war actually gave laborers, that actually increased the bargaining power of the laborers and it increased the wage rate, I think both agriculture wage rate and agriculture wage rate post Nareka. Now, especially in the case of agriculture waste rate, this affected the marginal and small farmers, because many of the farmers complained that half of the produce they get from their crop goes as labor wages. Now, farmers' perception was that one of the main complaints they had was it makes the work culture actually makes the laborers lazy. And they cited examples like labor quality decrease, like earlier laborers actually worked for 8 hours per day, now the net working hours has been reduced to 4 hours per day. Earlier you need 15% days to cultivate till 1 acre of land, but now you need 40% days. So that kind of perception, and some farmers were telling that it should be stopped in Kerala because it's already a labor scarce state. And again, some other farmers were of the opinion that we should include farm labor, especially for paddy in Nareka. And they were saying that government will pay, we'll also pay the labor, so the laborers get higher wages at all. Now, the question is whether it led to lowering of work rates. What we found was that there was a more labor market entrance in Nareka, but less to the farm labor. Now, when we ask why that happened, one is, of course, many older people who were farm laborers get into Nareka because not only because of the perception of light work, it's actually light work. In the sense that in the group, actually everyone shares the works of these old people, even if they don't do it completely. And in one case, we also found that there was a differentially able man who just registered and wasn't doing anything. So his work was shared by other people. And this actually, the laborers started working as a group, and they made it difficult for the overseers to measure the work. Actually, in many places, we found that measurement of work is not happening because the laborers didn't do it. And both the laborers and the overseers know that, that measurement, correct measurement won't be there when they will check. And as I said earlier, many scared but old farm laborers shifted to Nareka. And another thing was that laborers told us that they didn't want to work under pesky landlords who will constantly monitor what they were doing in the field. But that doesn't happen in Nareka. So what we found was there was an adverse effect on small and marginal paddy growers, and it also has a I mean, the farmers found it difficult to get labor, agriculture labor.